Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be talking about how I work with Sigma and the PR package that I received with all of their products that they sent me. I will also be doing a first impressions and a makeup tutorial on this look right here. So if you guys are interested, just keep on watching this video. Okay, so I only did my brows because obviously I'm going to be doing my makeup later on. So I'm just going to show you guys the products that I got first before I like do my first impressions and all that. So this is the box that I received in the mail. How exciting. This is my first PR package ever. So I was like crying when I got it. It was pretty awesome. So basically, when you become an affiliate with Sigma, that means that you sell their products and you receive commission. So I receive, I believe, 10% commission on any sales who use my coupon code. And I also have a tracking link that I have like in my Instagram. And I'll link like everything down below too in my description box. So yeah, I'll find out like when their deals come out, new products come out, let you guys know so you guys can use my discount and get some money off. Like, how exciting is that? So this is a beauty delivery. This is an envelope that I got. So basically it just has like all the paperwork. It tells you about being an affiliate. It lists all of their brush products. And then it has some of their makeup on the back too. And it also has like just a booklet talking about Sigma and how they came to be a brand and all that stuff. First, I'm gonna show you guys all the brushes that they sent me. These are all the brushes that they sent me. Woo! So they sent me their 3D HD Kabuki Brush. This is the 3D HD Kabuki Brush. Like kind of pointed surface. Now this is for pretty much getting into the corners like around your nose, and it just kind of fits the contour of your face to kind of make it more flawless. That way you don't have like patchy like build up around your nose, like if you missed like certain spots, like if you use a beauty blender or like a regular Kabuki brush. So this is just gets in to those corners a little bit easier for you. Okay, so then next they sent me their E05 Eyeliner Brush. See, obviously I haven't used any of it because I'm going to be using them today in this video. So they sent me this, which is very kind of them. And then they also sent me their Basics Eye Brush Kit. So this comes with another winged liner brush. This is the E06. And then they sent me the E30 Pencil Brush. They sent me the E55 Eye Shading Brush, the Medium Angled Shading Brush at E70. I don't know why I'm shaking. It's probably the pre-workout that I took before the gym this morning. And then this is the E60 Large Shader Brush, and the Small Angled Brush E65, which is awesome because I was needing a new eyebrow brush, so I have plenty of like angle brushes for eyeliner and all that stuff. And then they sent me the tapered blending brush at the E40. So that is super exciting. Like, I can't even afford their brushes, so for them to send me all of these is like so generous, and I'm so thankful for it. I can't believe that I got sent all of this. Now, this retails for $77. I believe this is $25. I'm not too sure how much this angle liner is, but like I said, I will list down the prices, products, whatever, all that jazz. So the next thing they sent me was their smokescreen palette. Now it does list all of the colors on the back and their names. So this is kind of like a neutral, smoky eyeshadow. You can use this for every day, or you can use it for a night out. So the packaging, it's kind of like, I wouldn't say cardboard, but it's a little bit more sturdy than cardboard. It's very, very good. So it's good for like if you're traveling and you need like a quick eyeshadow palette to take with, something very small and compact. And then you open it up and it has a nice large mirror, and then it has all your colors right there. You do have a lot of warm shades. You got your bold colors, like you got the lavender, the blue, you got your basic black, which is good. You got some transition shades, some metallic, some mattes. So it comes with a little bit of everything. So yes, I really like this. This retails for $39, and they do have quite a few palettes that you could choose from. So, Brushampoo. So these are brush cleaners. These are just little mini ones. Still haven't used them. Haven't used any of this. And then they sent me a makeup brush cleaning mat, and I actually have used that. So let me go grab that real quick. This has a spot for your, Jesus, this is floppy. Eyeshadow brushes, like your smaller brushes, your big brushes like face bronzer, contour. It also has rinsing stations, or is it rinsing stations right here, and then like deeper clean spots right in here. So that's really great. This definitely comes in handy for your brushes. I use it, and it was like the fastest I ever cleaned all of my brushes, and I have like a million. So yeah, I really like it. And then it also comes with these little suction cups on the back, so you pretty much just slide it right into your sink and it suction cups to the bottom, and then it's just like really quick and easy cleaning for your brushes. So I really like it. And then I will dry it off and I will just suction cup it onto my wall and let it air dry a little bit more for my next use. So yes, I need their Wicked gel eyeliner. Now I've been wanting this for like 5 years. I just never like got around to it. I always had like other gel liners. I kind of went to liquid liners, so it's nice to bring the old gel liner back. So I'm excited to use this today. I heard that this has really, really, really good staying power, and it's like very jet black. And then the last product that they sent me was their Sigma Bloody Good Power Stick. Now this is a lipstick, so this is a true red. I mean, it even has the Sigma logo on the lipstick, for crying out loud. I mean, like, can that get any better? And the cap is magnetic! Look at that! They sent me the Lip Eclipse in the shade Rosette. Now this is a glossy pigmented pink lip gloss. I will be using this today. To use my coupon code for any of these products, or if you want to look at their other products and purchase anything, I will link it down below. It is Makeup by Macey. You can do all caps or you can do lowercase. It really doesn't matter. It's not like case sensitive or anything. So I'll be using almost everything. I do have another eyeshadow palette because I wanted to do a cotton candy theme today. So I do have some other colors. I will use maybe a couple colors from the eyeshadow palette. Let's get right into the tutorial. The first transition shade I'm going to be taking a blush from Coastal Scents. It is just a neon pink shade. And I'm going to be using the Sigma E40 brush to use it into my crease for my first shade. And I'm going to keep it kind of like right above my eye. I'm just going to go in with the shape of my eye and take it a little bit above. I'll be using some of my brushes too. Just because all these brushes can't really make like a full eye look, at least not for the look that I'm doing. I'll be using the Morphe M441. This is my ride or die crease brush. I've been using this for like over a year. I'll use this color. So I'm gonna go in with another Coastal Scents blush. This is like a darker raspberry shade. And I'm gonna take it a little bit closer into my crease this time. Like I said, we want that gradient effect, so it'll get darker as it fades down in windshield wiper motions. And then I will dip it into the product as I need more. Tap off the excess and continue the crease. For the next brush, I'll be using the Morphe M433. Might be Hot Tamale. No, this is not Hot Tamale, but I can't remember the name of these. So I'm gonna be using this darker hot pink into my crease right here. This is really pigmented. So make sure you have a light hand when you tend to see that some shadows are more pigmented. Just use a light hand, because if you go in like too hard, you will have harsh lines that are hard to blend out. And blend those edges at the very top. And then it doesn't matter if you get it like done in here, because I will be taking a makeup wipe at the end and wiping it. I'm gonna take these in my inner and outer corners. So I'm gonna take this very dark blue up here. It's like a dark navy. It's very beautiful. And I'm taking the Morphe E18. Now this is a dense, small crease brush, so this will get into certain parts of the eye that you want. And I'm kind of following the shape of my eyelid. As long as you follow the shape of your eyelid, it's gonna make eyeshadow so much easier for you instead of trying and making your own shape. Like that. And it's all right if you get it like in the inner corner, because like I said, you'll take a makeup wipe and clean that all up later. And I'm going to very lightly connect the two. So it's a very, very, very diffuse. I see that it's making purple. Now that I notice it, the blue and the pink mixed together is making a purple, and I'm not gonna argue with that. I mean, I love purple. And then I will be blending these edges. No harsh edges. I've said this from the very beginning, people. No harsh edges. See how it's starting to kind of diffuse the color a little bit? From the blending, sometimes that can take the pigment away from the darker shade. So I'm just gonna go back in with the blue and the E18. And just like lightly dab it and fill in those gaps. What are the odds that one of my YouTube video songs is playing on the TV right now? It was meant to be! It was meant to be! Just repeat these same stuff until I'm satisfied. For the lid shade, I'm going to take the color from the Sigma palette, this light blue. This is the shade Nebula. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to dab just my ring finger into it. And then I'm going to dab it into the middle. Usually I do like right above the pupil. Like when I'm looking straight into my mirror, I'll do right above the pupil. Since this is a super light metallic blue, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a flat brush. I'm just gonna take this Mikasa Beauty E230 brush, which I also have a coupon code for, Makeup by Macey. I think you received 25% off. So I will take this. Make sure you get enough on your brush, and then I'm just going to wet the brush down. I'm gonna use the Slay All Day Setting Spray by Gerard Cosmetics. And I'm just gonna dab it right in the middle. I'm gonna take that Sigma blue shade and dab it on the outsides. That's pretty. I always go by the arch of my brow right here. So I'll line my finger up. Like that. Okay, here we go, baby boo. So I'm dipping the brush into the eyeliner. And a lot of times I will just wipe the excess off my hand, like I do that with my eyebrow pomade. I'll wipe the excess off. Try to holler and try to holler and try to holler and try to holler and try to 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 try I'm going to line this on the top of my eyeliner. So just bear with me here. Now this I really have to be careful. Hopefully you guys can see this. Colossal Big Shot. It's very hard. Now I like to let each layer of this glitter liner dry, because if you put it in while it's wet, it's just gonna move around that glitter, so I'm gonna let it dry. Okay, so I'm going to wait for this lash to dry, pop it on, and then I'm gonna do my other eye, do my lash, and I'm gonna come back and I will do the rest of my face for you guys. I'll be right back. All right, I'm back. I did my eye makeup and I did add a little bit of silver liner over my eyelid. I did have to go in with my NYX liquid liner because the Sigma one was just not working out for me. It was like too hard to work with and I couldn't get it like pigmented enough in the inner corner and stuff. So I just went over it with my NYX liquid liner and it looks better now. So I already primed my face with the Lorac Light Source 3-in-1 Illuminating Primer. This is in the shade Dawn. So now I'm going to use the IT Cosmetics Illumination CC Cream. This is in the shade Light. This is a little bit darker for me, but I use this shade in the summer and I'll go back to Fair for fall and winter. So I'm going to use this with the new 3D HD Kabuki Brush by Sigma. I'm probably going to take off my earrings just so I don't get anything on them. Put it all over my face. This stuff does dry fast, so you do have to kind of work very quickly with it. Okay. All right, here we go. I like how it's easy to get into the corners of my face without messing up the rest of it like a beauty blender would. I can get right above my brows without having to worry about smudging those or anything. I do my cream contour before I do my concealer. I don't know, that's just how I do it. Line my forehead. My jawline. And then I just dot it right in here. I'm gonna try and use this Kabuki. I'm a little nervous though. Tarte Shape Tape. This is in the shade Light. I I put it on the sides of my nose to clean up my nose contour. I'm gonna set my concealer with my Tarte clay paint palette. I'm just gonna use this nude shade. These two bronzer shades with my Morphe M527 brush to set my cream contour. They are so pigmented that you only need, like, that's it. Like, that is it. You'll see. Broken blush brush. This is the E4, I believe. I just haven't gotten super glued to put it back onto the handle. So I'm gonna take this. Regular powder brush, this is the E3, and I just take the tip of it and just kind of blend the blush in so it doesn't look too harsh. Oh, I'm going to take the LA Girl Glide Gel Liner in the shade, I don't know what shade this is, Paradise Purple. E55 shading brush. It's a little bit denser than the other shading brush. And I'm gonna dip it in to, God, I don't even know. Probably gonna dip it into this dark purple right here. I'm gonna take my Morphe M441, dip it into this neon pink, and smoke it out even more. My cat is literally watching me right now.
Why are you pooping, baby? Are you watching, mommy? Are you watching your mommy?
Breathe in, leave it all behind. This is the Anastasia Nicole Guerrero Glow Kit, and it is the best thing that I have probably ever tried in my life, besides Coco Bling by Artist Couture. I do love that too. I'm probably gonna use Kitty Cat, the pink one. So I have my highlighting brushes. I have the M501 by Morphe, and then I have the E36 by Morphe, but I might use the pencil brush. I don't know. Yeah, I'm gonna use the pencil brush by Sigma for my detail highlight. This is the E30. And then I'm gonna go in and wet my brush and do a second layer. So still dipping into Kitty Cat, tapping off the excess and spraying the brush, and then tapping it back in, and yeah. Finish off the look, I'm gonna first put my earrings back in. These are from Kohl's. These are J-Lo earrings. And then this is from Forever 21, if anyone was wondering. All right, for the lips, I'm gonna use the Sigma Lip Eclipse in the shade Rosette. The Slay All Day Setting Spray. This is the scent Coconut by Gerard Cosmetics. This will soak up any excess powder and this will set your makeup so it lasts all day long. It looks absolutely amazing. I'm so happy with these products. A lot of these turned out. The only thing I didn't like was the gel liner. I'm gonna give it a few tries and I'll let you guys know, like, a couple makeup looks. I'll give it a try again and we'll see. So thank you guys for watching my video. This is the finished look. I had tons of fun filming this. If you guys like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel as always, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.